Well, thank you, Taylor, and thanks to the Alum Council. I really appreciate this. It was an unexpected honor. There are so many people here that deserve this sort of honor. I really didn't think I'd receive this. The first person I'd really like to thank, though, is my wife, my wonderful wife, Sally, for supporting me. She would run the household and do everything while I'm up here for a week at a time, several times a year, and she just gave me wonderful support. She also sacrifices part of our dining room table for the several projects that I have going on at any particular time. And one summer she sacrificed the patio while I had worked on the dinosaur. Dinosaur haunts. I was trying to learn how to make organ pipes, and that seems to be a closely held secret by the organ pipe companies, but I finally discovered it, and all these horrible tweets and grunts and noises that emanated until I finally figured out how to do it. The next person I'd like to thank is Don Loughran. Don has created the best working atmosphere I've ever experienced. I can't tell you how delightful it is to work in the museum. And you know, you get an award for work. Well, this isn't work, this is fun. And this has just been an extraordinary experience to contribute to the museum that he's created with all the people he's surrounded himself with are just the very best. And I can't tell you what a delight it is to work there. Now, I'd like to thank Ray, but you know, Ray's not here to thank. And the reason I'd like to do that is about 10 or 12 years ago, Don asked me to help him work in the archives. And he was trying to organize this jumble of stuff that people had left in the museum. There were thousands of photographs and slides and all kinds of memorabilia from years past. And he was trying to organize into some chronological order. And he asked me to help him identify people that were in the photographs. Well, in reading the archives, going through the archives, I found that Ray Alf had run the peccary trips all those years out of his own pocket. I always thought these trips were a school function, and to the extent that students went on the trips, they were. But Ray ran these trips out of his pocket. And I was really struck by that, and it just changed the course of my life, because Ray invited me to go on trips, and our family didn't always have the money to pay. But I went on these trips anyway. Ray saw to it that I went on the trips he wanted me to go on. And so this is my way of giving back is to, I don't have a lot of money, but I do have a lot of skills I've learned through my career. And I am very glad to be able to use those skills to repay the museum in the only way I know. And, oh, I forgot one little fact in there, that Thompson Webb charged Ray L. 7 cents a mile to use a school vehicle. Anybody know that? It was pretty amazing. Did you ever wonder why Ray L. always drove a Chevy Suburban field vehicle? Well, I think that's the reason. I don't think the Chevy Suburban was probably Pearl's first choice of the family vehicle, but she put up with it. Now, the last thing I'd like to do is use this award to try and inspire somebody else, or many people, to follow in my stead, to do what I'm doing in the museum. I'm not going to last forever, and I need some help. Come after me to help keep the museum going like it has been in the past. So with that, thank you very much. Thank the Alum Council, and most of all, thank you, Doug and Sally.